Maryland Newsline, how can your phone tell you if you're in an unsafe relationship?
A possible cut to your income tax rates and a boost to cybersecurity. We'll be live from Annapolis with the latest. Good evening and welcome to Maryland Newsline. I'm Nicholas Munson.
And I'm Emily Stern. But first, 4 years later, and progress is finally being made for victims of domestic violence. Domestic violence affects one in three women, and now Congress is considering a bill that would declare May 3rd National One Love Day in commemoration of Yardley Love, a Maryland girl who died a victim of an abusive relationship. I was at Towson University today to learn more about the bill and its namesake.
She'd light up room when she came in.
Yardley Love was a senior at the University of Virginia when her ex-boyfriend George Hughley attacked and killed her on May 3rd, 2010.
You don't ever think that this could happen, and not, it probably won't happen, but it can happen.
2 million people are physically assaulted by an intimate partner each year.
I was floored to learn just how pervasive this challenge is.
On Valentine's Day, Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger introduced a bill that would declare May 3rd National One Love Day, a day intended to raise awareness and encourage reflection about domestic abuse.
This is the type of common sense legislation that hopefully should sail through Congress.
We hope that people will sit back and evaluate and reflect on their situation.
National One Love Day is named after the foundation that Yardley's mother Sharon and sister Lexi founded 4 years ago after Yardley's death. The foundation's most recent project is the My Plan mobile app, which helps women determine if they or their friends are in an unsafe relationship. Yardley's mother says the family's tragedy is something she never could have imagined.
We never spanked our children. My husband carried the kids on his shoulder like queens.
Sharon says she will continue her mission to see that no other family suffers the same kind of loss. For more information about the One Love Foundation or to download the free My Plan mobile app, go to joinonelove.org.
While the atmosphere was mostly positive in Towson, down the road in Annapolis, the U.S. Naval Academy is mourning the loss of one of their own. According to the Academy, 25-year-old midshipman Max Allen of Chesterfield, Virginia, died over the weekend after his SUV crashed into College Creek on base. Navy investigators say they are still looking into the cause and exact time of the crash. Allen was slated to serve in the aviation community as a naval officer after graduation in May.
And in Montgomery County tonight, a man has been charged with the murder of his 3-year-old son. 36-year-old Brian O'Callaghan of Damascus is charged with first-degree murder and child abuse in the death of Hyun Soo O'Callaghan, who was adopted 3 months earlier from Korea. Montgomery County police say that the child became unresponsive while O'Callaghan was caring for him while his wife was out of town. A medical examiner ruled the death a homicide from multiple blunt impacts.
In Annapolis tonight, would you like to save an extra $176 per year? How about $750? Today, Republican lawmakers unveiled a new plan to put money back in your pockets. Lindsay Simpson now joins us live from our Annapolis Bureau with more. Lindsay? We're sorry for the technical difficulties.
Thanks anyway, Lindsay. And speaking of Annapolis, it's not often that we see a convicted criminal running for the General Assembly, but it's happening. Julius Henson just announced he will be running as a Democrat for Baltimore's 45th District Senate seat. Henson served a 30-day jail term in 2012 after being convicted of conspiracy in a case involving robocalls made to black voters on Election Day 2010 in the hopes of keeping them from the polls. Henson says he will formally file on Thursday.
Whether it's the Metro being late every day or waiting in bumper-to-bumper traffic on the way home, transportation in Maryland can give you a major headache. CNS TV's Nicole Jones is in Montgomery College, where the gubernatorial candidates will give their take on transportation in Maryland. Sorry, we're having technical difficulties. We'll get back to Nicole in a moment.
And coming up on Maryland Newsline, we have some more news for you. Whether it's waiting for the metro or driving on the roads, this winter has been rough.
And a new plan for tighter fuel efficiency standards for big rigs brings President Obama to Prince George's County. We'll take you there.
Plus, speed cameras, they seem to be watching drivers everywhere they turn, but could a change be on the horizon? Find out more next.
Shelters are the best places to find a new pet.
You little rascal.
That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals.
Oh, ladies first.
Eager to become a part of your family. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
We are rolling.
All right, Mama's gonna bring you home. Mama's
okay.
Challenge your kids to be active and eat healthy.
Right, let's see what you can do. Let's go.
Search We Can for ideas on how to get healthy together.
I'm starving. What's for breakfast?
Guten Tag!
Johannes Brahms!
I bring you arts-enriched raisin blams, fortified with increased test scores and creative problem-solving skills.
It's good!
And good for you.
Bobby? Susie?
Don't worry, that's just the power of the arts!
Feed your kids the arts. For 10 simple ways to learn how, visit AmericansForTheArts.org.
Live with a human for a while and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floors stay so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
If you drive a car, you're probably concerned about how many miles per gallon you get.
But for tractor-trailer drivers, their vehicles are less than fuel efficient. However, a new plan by President Obama might be the relief they need. CNS TV's Regina Hamm was on hand in Upper Marlboro earlier to find out about this new plan.
Workers at the Safeway Distribution Center in Upper Marlboro were among the first to hear President Obama's next step in economic growth. The president mentioned new initiatives for unemployment, manufacturing, and dependence on foreign oil. He stressed that economic growth means equal chances for everyone.
We've got to build an economy that works for everybody, not just the fortunate few.
President Obama today focused on the economy, but he specifically talked about automobile manufacturers and how one of his goals is to make these big trucks more fuel efficient. The president made his push for tighter fuel regulations and reduced carbon emissions beginning in 2018.
Set in motion the first ever national policy aimed at both increasing gas mileage and decreasing greenhouse gas pollution for all new cars and trucks sold in the United States.
Members of the automobile industry applauded President Obama's efforts, but some worried about the cost.
To trucks, we have concerns about the federal excise tax, which is 12%. If we could get some relief from that, I think it would really help people to be able to buy these new technologies.
Regardless of any potential roadblocks, people like Steve Queen feel optimistic about the president's agenda.
President Obama wants to have all carbon emissions decrease by 25% and have cars have a 55-mile-per-gallon efficiency rate by 2018.
Two new major polls show that many Marylanders are having a hard time deciding on who they want to see to become the next governor. Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown announced his candidacy last year and currently holds a 21-point lead over Attorney General Doug Gansler. But the polls show that 40% of voters are still undecided. The polls also show that almost half of Democratic voters are less likely to vote for Gansler in light of the underage party pictures that surfaced at the end of last year. Similarly, 25% of voters will be less likely to vote for Brown after the troubled health care exchange rollout.
Could you soon be seeing wind turbines off the coast of Ocean City? Earlier today, Virginia-based company Dominion Resources said it plans to bid on a lease for an area of ocean preserved for the development of an 80,000-acre wind farm. The area is 10 to 30 miles off the coast of Ocean City and will potentially generate over 1,400 megawatts of power. The auction is set to take place later this year.
Ever been caught by speed camera? Yeah, join the club. But a group of lawmakers in Annapolis is looking to reform legislation involving these cameras. CNS-TV's Woody Wilder has the latest from Annapolis.
Some say speed cameras are effective for traffic enforcement. Others say they're used by local governments to just raise money. And many drivers complain that they're wrongly ticketed. Ron Ely with the Maryland Drivers Alliance has a quick fix for those erroneous tickets.
Well, one solution would be to get rid of the cameras.
According to Ely, inaccurate tickets are a problem across the state.
So there's definitely a problem with some of the systems in the state. Our organization has been looking around other parts of the states and we found a lot of problems elsewhere.
Baltimore is one of the worst offenders of inaccurate tickets.
The error rate looks like, according to the audits done by the city, it's anywhere from 10 to 40%. Which is outrageous.
For many of you, speed cameras have been an inconvenience for the old wallet. But if this reform passes, you won't be the only one having to pay up. Cardin is sponsoring a bill which, among other things, calls for a civil fine of $1,000 for the individual responsible for maintaining the system which issued the inaccurate ticket.
If, in fact, the vendors are being honest that their error rates is 1 in 1,000, and they should have no problem paying that $1,000 fine once a year.
But if it comes down to man versus machine or man versus man, Ron Ely says he'll take human every time.
If a police officer is holding a radar gun, they have immediate secondary evidence, their own eyewitness testimony.
In the legislation, there's something for everyone to agree with.
You love speed cameras, you will love the bill. If you hate speed cameras, you will love the bill.
At the State House, Woody Wilder, CNS-TV.
AAA Mid-Atlantic says it will continue to support speed cameras as a safety tool if the system is fixed. The Auto Club says when operated properly, speed cameras can change the motorist behavior, reduce speeds, and cut the number of traffic fatalities.
And I think we can all agree that those who plowed the roads this past week deserve some credit, but not all local residents may agree with that.
Just be sick of winter altogether, but some people don't mind it sticking around a little bit longer. We'll explain next.
Say.
She said whatever.
No, she says that all the time.
What's that?
Hello? I'm on the phone. Mom, I'm on the phone! Hello? I'm on the phone.
Who's this? It's me. I'm on the phone. Mom?
Oh, you're on the phone. All right. Sorry.
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 Anyway.
Who are you talking to? Kelly?
Mom.
All right.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
So, I got this new family. And I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy all day long. Tap, 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 tap. Oh, and she even talks to it. She talks to that more than she talks to him. What's up, bro? Nice shirt. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
Wake the sun. I've begun to dream of things to come, and tell the trees not to look for me. I'm going to find some peace of mind. Wake the sun, wake the sun. Sun, wake the sun.
Whether it is the metro being late every day,
and we have Nicole Jones back with us. She's at Montgomery College, where the gubernatorial candidates will discuss transportation. Are you there, Nicole?
Thanks, Nick. Tonight, supporters, labor groups, students, and elected officials are all here to listen to the gubernatorial candidates speak on their position on Maryland's transportation. Right now, before the event begins, the candidates are with the supporters doing a special presentation and having light refreshments. There are also campaigners outside for Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown and Heather Mazur passing out pamphlets and getting people excited for their campaign. As of right now, Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown, Attorney General Doug Gansler, Delegate Ron George, Charles Lawler, and Delegate Heather Mazur are all going to be here tonight. The event will be moderated by Montgomery College Vice President Dr. Brad Stewart, and he will introduce the candidates and have a Q&A with them. Now, the questions are already pre-written, so the audience won't be able to participate, but the candidates will give their vision for the future and what they decide and what they would like to see done if elected governor. As you know, the Purple Line Project is a hot topic, and the event is hosted by Purple Line Now, so that is expected to be talked about the most tonight.
Thanks, Nicole. The hour-long event will begin at 7 p.m. at the Montgomery County Cultural Arts Center in Tacoma Park.
And we know snow can cause problems on the road, but have you ever had it affect your home windows? Several Rockville and Germantown residents living along I-270 did, and now the Maryland State Highway Administration is apologizing. According to a state highway spokesman, rocks and ice tossed up by plows on the road are to blame for multiple broken windows last week. They say it is completely unacceptable and those affected can get reimbursed. You can call and file a claim with the state treasurer's office at 1-800-942-0162.
Is it possible we... With this morning's quick snowstorm, temperatures are predicted to rise into the high 50s, maybe even hit 60 later this week. But while many of us may be looking forward to warmer days ahead, CNS-TV's Margot Shear found a place today that actually goes by the motto, the colder, the better.
This morning, it was time to do it again. To dust off the car, perhaps one last time. Hasn't it been enough?
My boy's been home from school for like 5 days in Montgomery County. They went in 2 hours late today, but I'm glad to see him go back. It's a mess.
A mess it is, and it's been the seventh straight week that our area has had a school delay or closing. And although the kids may not be tired of it, a lot of folks are.
I just made it harder, more difficult, traffic.
And with traffic comes cars and lots of car problems.
But with temperatures reaching near 60 on Friday, the snow will be all gone, which means bad news for car repair shops.
Just like here at Meineke Car Care, where it's been a busy winter.
The colder it is, the harder it is on cars. So potholes, salt, any extreme environment breaks cars down.
And those potholes can be hard on the tires and can cost you anywhere from a couple hundred to thousands of dollars to fix.
I'm here to pick up some tires, and then sometimes I do some little service on my car.
Felicity Stanley says she buys new tires ahead of the winter to try to head off problems when the bad weather hits.
It's been tough, but like everybody else, I just go slowly.
But no matter how slow many of us think the winter is going at this point, one thing's for sure. Summer is in sight.
Ocean City. I'm waiting for Ocean City.
In College Park, Margot Shear, CNS TV.
Although warmer weather will be teasing us throughout the week, unfortunately, meteorologists are predicting 30s again early next week.
Oh, man. That's Maryland Newsline for tonight. You can find out more about the stories presented here by going to our website, cnsmaryland.org. We'll see you here again tomorrow night, same time.
Have a good night.